We were sitting on the wall upon a Sunday, just to watch the girls go by, and thinking we'd be married to one day, when Caitlin caught our eye. Yeah, the man, she was the makings of a fairy, and it made each by us swear. There's not one girl in the whole wide world like a darling girl from Clare. So every man has got the finest plan you'd ever see now, but me now. And every day, just one of them would say that she's a bree now. You'll see now, all night they'd fight as to which of them was right in the colour of her eyes and hair. And not a word from me was ever heard about the darling girl from Clare. Now, Sir Sweeney, tis the father I be blazing. I tell him of the land I've tilled. I tell him of the cattle I have grazing, and of the house I mean to build. And when he sees the arables and pasture, and the fat stock feeding there, and the hens and the chickens, you may go to the dickens for the darling girl from Clare. So every man has got the finest plan you'd ever see now, pardon me now. And every day there's one of them would say that she'll agree now. You'll see now, things I will now. Though I haven't heard a cow of brass, I've got my share. And so I know the way they ought to go about the darling girl from Clare. Now it's the shafty, she'll be coming to the shop here for to buy some sort of thing. I'll ask her if she has a mind to stop there, and should I buy the ring. And when she sees the curtains on the window and the outlook on the stairs, keeping time to the minute, no one else will be in it with the darling girl from Clare. So every man has got the finest plan you'd ever see now, but me now. And every day there's one of them would say that she'll agree now. You'll see now, things I you may stop till you bend in your shop, and not a hair she'll care. And with all your gold you'll never hold a horse upon the darling girl from Clare. Now I never said a single word about her, but I met the girl that day. I told her I could never live without her, and what had she to say? Well, she said that you might go and see me father, so I met him then and there. And in less than an hour we were fighting for the dower of the Darwin girl from Clare. So every man had got the finest plan you'd ever see now, but me now. And every day one of them would say that she'd agree now. You'd see now, but late last night, while the moon was shining bright, I asked her if she'd share in me joys and me sorrows, and by God, on tomorrow I'll be married to the girl from